So let me express my sincere happiness in joining this event again, which has been very dedicatedly organized by Mr. and Mrs. Palalkar for so many years to focus on a very important aspect of energy, which in fact was one of the missing link in this entire energy chain for many, many centuries. Almost since the electricity was discovered or invented, we have been facing this problem of storage. And if we can get a storage of energy, many of these challenges related to energy can really be addressed very effectively. We have been thinking about one aspect of that, and that is something like carbon capture and storage, which is sequestering the carbon which comes out of a fossil fuel energy. But that's something post it is consumed, and to deal with the ill effect of the greenhouse gas emission on climate change. If you can capture it and store it, or capture it and use it, this problem gets solved. But energy storage is such an important issue that particularly when you generate electricity, if you can store it and then you can use it when you need it, it can change a completely, it can bring in a complete new dynamics into the entire energy spectrum. So I really congratulate both of them for organizing the event on a continuous basis. As far as India is concerned, we already embarked upon a very ambitious target of 100,000 megawatt of solar, 75,000 megawatt of wind. This is in quest of making India over a period of time a carbon neutral country. We are a signatory and we have been a strong proponent of Paris Accord. Prime Minister Narendra Modi played a very key role along with President Obama, who was the president at that time of the US, United States, and President Hollande, who was the president of France, to play a key role in making this Paris Accord possible, which was in a way very historic, because till that time we are still struggling to get an agreement on how to combat with ill effects of climate change. Having done that, and India is now on path of reaching the target of 175,000 megawatts of solar and wind put together, challenges are going to come if we don't have energy storage. Along with that, we are in the process of generating cleaner sources of energy. We have many gasification plant. We are trying to work on many issues about clean coal initiatives and many others. So just imagine, if we get renewable energy on one hand, we have a clean energy on the other, and we can blend all that into making it one form of energy to be delivered to the consumer, and that can really change the entire thinking about the climate change as well. And to do that, we need storage. And storage is now going to be the new thrust area. So I'm very happy that in this one whole of week, we are going to discuss all aspects of energy storage chain, right from materials to new R&D avenues, how the startups are working on that, how the industry looks at it, how the government has any views on that, all aspects of that. And this brings together the top class thinkers, policymakers, scientists, industry, everybody together. So I must congratulate you for doing that. As a cabinet minister of energy, as well as many other nine portfolios in India, I've always been a strong votary of making India a hub for manufacturing, which Prime Minister Modi has talked about first, Make in India, which I was looking after as a commerce and industry minister, and now Atmanirbhar Bharat. That means that we'll have to be self-reliant on from energy security perspective. That's why the renewable energy, which will make us energy, domestic energy source of energy can be harnessed, and therefore energy security will be addressed. But unless we make energy storage, also all aspects of that to be made in India, it will really not help us to realize the true potential of it. And to do that, even materials will play a key role. In fact, if you really look at it, the future of the world, as he says, is threatened by climate change, but the future of the world will be shaped, on the other hand, by materials. What kind of materials we are going to use in future is going to determine the success or the failure of any enterprise of the future. And particularly, when some of the critical materials, which are really necessary for making storage of energy, the battery, will also depend upon some of these rare earths, which could go into that. Therefore, making the kind of material that we need is going to be very important. So right from materials, we need to do planning for making Atmanirbhar Bharat a reality. Then the question that comes of making it in India. So there will be a lot of components that are required. An ecosystem needs to be developed. A large number of small and medium enterprises will benefit from it, even if the large storage comes into play. So many different component manufacturers will form the ecosystem. All of that needs to be thought of, and I'm very happy that in this Energy Week, we are going to discuss almost all aspects related to that. There are also challenges. When you make battery, what happens once the battery is used? Then the energy storage equipments are going to be used and then finally have to be discarded. Where are they going to discard them? What happens about it? If they go back into the system and they cause another form of pollution, is going to be a problem. So we have to think about that even today, and I'm very happy that in Energy Week, you are even discussing about it. So you are discussing about a birth of a battery storage equipment, but you are thinking about a post-death issues related to the energy storage. And therefore, this aspect is very important. How can you retrieve the material? How can you reprocess it? How can you recycle it? How can you reuse it? These aspects also will get adequately addressed. Let me appeal to all of those who are interested in manufacturing battery storage or battery equipments or energy storage equipments in India. Please join hands with us to realize the vision of our Prime Minister Narendra Modi to make India as the next energy hub. As you know, the incremental use of energy is the highest in India now. Among the countries which are the major energy users, we may be number three in terms of total energy user per se, but in terms of incremental energy use, India is becoming probably the biggest and will become even bigger as we go along. And therefore, making India as a hub for energy storage makes sense, because if we are going to be the energy users, then making energy storage as India as a destination will really help all those who will be thinking of investing in India. I can assure you it will be a great success story. I'm sure you are bringing together all other players that were critical, like the financiers, like all those who make this manufacturing a reality. So all the developers, R&D players, financiers, actual manufacturers, actual users, all of them will participate and have a sort of a vichar manthan, a thought, a churning of thoughts to bring about new ideas to fore. So let me congratulate you. Let me congratulate Mr. and Mrs. Wagalkar for doing this for so many years in such a dedicated way. I am sure they also have stored energy. Otherwise, it is not possible for anybody to continuously keep doing something like this for so many years, so effectively, so efficiently, so motivatedly. I hope their stored energy will be an inspiration for others to work on energy storage. Thank you very much. Congratulations to you.